Hi there everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today we can take a look at how to calibrate your DJI drone's gimbal manually using a Python script. Now please note, this does not support all DJI drones, and I'll show you which drones are supported in the video that follows. If you like the content that I'm making, please consider to subscribe. It really helps out the channel. Now there's going to be quite a few steps. I'm going to list them all in the description below. But the first step is you have to download Python. Just type in Python download in Google and you'll find your link that you need to go to. Now once on the site, go to the download page, and on the download page you're going to select the one for your system. And this is now specifically for Windows. I'm running a Windows 10 machine, therefore I'm just going to download the file that I require. Next you're going to have to download pyserial. And this is quite a tricky one, because once you've downloaded, you need to have another file to uncompress it. So go to the PGY or pyserial site, and then once you're on the site, click on download files, and you will be shown the options available. In this case, you're gonna see this one, pyserial, at the bottom. That's 3.5.tar.gz. That's the file that we need to download. Now, once we've downloaded the file, we're going to need a file to be able to extract it. Since this is a .tar.gz file, we'll need a unzipping or uncompressed program that can handle it. In my opinion, the 7-zip program is probably the best. It's freeware, so just type in 7-zip, go to the site, click the one that you require, in my case a 64-bit version. Now we're not done yet. We still need to download the DJI firmware tools file. Very simple. Go to Google, type in DJI firmware tools, and the ODGS one is going to be probably the one that's going to pop up first on GitHub. Click on the link and just confirm that it is the correct one. You can see the files that I've got on my screen, and on the right side there's a code option. Click on that and then you can download the zip file. Now this is the actual files that we'll be using to run the actual calibration. Python and pyserial will just be used to enable us to use the files in this folder or zip file. So once it's downloaded, we have to go to our downloads directory and we're going to start unzipping and uncompressing the files. But before we continue, we need to install Python first. So go to your downloads directory and double click the python.exe, and it's going to start installing it, and then wait for it to complete. Now in my case, I've already got it installed, but it's an older version, so I'm just going to proceed with the upgrade process. It's not going to take too long, but I'll just fast forward this little section so it doesn't waste too much time. After that's done, we need to unzip the files in the correct location. So go to your downloads directory, or just go to your C drive first, create a DJI folder. I've already done that. And in that directory, you are going to put your files. So in your downloads directory, you can go and unzip, or just go to the 7-zip and then extract the files to the same location. Once that's done, you're going to get your pyserial directory, and you can do the same with the firmware tools. Now once that's done, go into the pyserial directory. You'll see there's a .tar directory. Go inside that and then extract the .tar file. Once extracted, you need to take or copy the file. In my case, I'm just going to cut or move the file to the directory that I created on my C drive called DJI. So cut the file, in my case, and then go to C drive, go to the DJI directory. You can see it's already there. I'm just going to replace it. So in this case, replace everything. So I've got the latest files there. And then I'm going to do the exact same thing with the firmware files. So I've already unzipped it. Just connect the entire directory just as it is, cut it, move it to my DJI directory on my C drive, and then I should be ready to start the process. Now open the DJI folder after you're done extracting it or replacing it, and then inside you're going to find a file that is called com_og_service_tools. Just check it's there. If it's there, right click on it and then open with a notepad. As you guys can see, I've just right clicked, selected open with. I'm not going to always use it. And this is going to show us all of the supported drones. So this little text file you see over here, I typically copy the contents out of it so I can work with it. But if you scroll through it, you're going to see a list of all the drones that this firmware tools is going to support. So it's always a good thing. If you're just doing one drone, obviously just use the model number you want. In my case, I want to save all of it. So I'm just going to add a new window, copy all of the model numbers or drone serial codes. So in this case, just highlight all of them. And then I'm going to copy it to another file. The advantage of doing this is that I'll be able to put the commands and everything else in the other file without having to work on the actual config file. Remember, you don't want to make changes to this file because you're going to mess up the whole firmware tools. So I'm just going to copy it out, paste into another file, and in this case I'll be looking at a Mavic 2 code. So I've got other drones here as well, but I'm going to do the first test on the Mavic 2 one, and later I'm going to do it on the Mavic Air 2 as well as the Air 1. I've done it on a Spark as well, and if you look at the list, there's quite a number of other drones. Now what you need to do is you need to open the command prompt in administrator mode, and once you've done that, you need to navigate to your DJI directory. Now remember, the reason we did this on the C drive is to make it easy, so just type in CD / enter, and then you can type in DAR to see what's in the folder. Then you can type in DJI firmware tools, and you can navigate to that directory. Now the idea is to go to the DJI firmware tools directory, because that is where the com_og_service_tool file is. That is the script that we're going to initiate with the additional COM ports as well as your drone model number to be able to perform the gimbal calibration. Now if you guys find the content useful, please remember to press the subscribe button and also the like. If there's anything you guys would like me to do specifically or unclear on, please mention it in the comments below so that I can follow up and make sure everyone's on the same page. Now with regards to the gimbal calibration, remember I said I was going to do the Mavic 2 Pro first, and the way you do this is you're going to have to hook up your drone to your PC, and once that's done you need to get the correct COM port, and you do this by going to the device manager, and you do this by right click on the PC, clicking the manage option box. And then you're going to see there is a device manager option. Once you click on that, just scroll down until you can see the ports location or the option, and you'll just take note of what the port number is. In this case, you can see the port number is number 12. Therefore, I need to go to my script and change the port number to number 12. I also need to change the drone model number so that it matches the Mavic 2 Zoom drone. In the beginning, we copied all the model numbers out into a separate text file. So in this case, I'm just going to copy the example files from the description in this video below, and that's the script for the actual gimbal calibration. Then I'm going to take a look at what model number my drone is. You can see here it's WM240. I'm going to copy that and put it into my script. As you can see, I just paste into the same text document, makes life so much easier, and you can just replace the files. So in this case, COM12 and WM240. And you'll see there are two scripts to run. First, you copy the top one, which is the joint one, and you're going to run it in your command prompt. So just if you copy it, you can just right click in the command prompt and press enter. Once you press it, you'll see the gimbal start to rotate and perform its calibration. But remember, it's not doing a full calibration. You still need to run the other script as well. I always run the first script twice just to confirm that everything is running properly, because typically I'm busy with a script as well as maybe starting off with the second script as well. I just want to make sure everything runs properly. You'll notice that there's going to be an error that pops up at the bottom. It doesn't get the feedback from the script as it would like with a Spark or the older drones, but it still triggers the calibration as you can see. So here I'm just running it again, just to make sure everything runs properly and the gimbal is nice and clear, nothing was obstructing it. Once I know the gimbal calibration is complete or can do the whole process, it's fine to do the second script. So you can just go to your text document, right click the script, copy and right click, and then you can just run it from there. Second script typically takes like 2 or 3 seconds to just get started. As you can see there, it starts to tilt and pivot. The second script takes a bit longer than the first one. So don't be worried too much if it takes up to 30 seconds to complete, but in most cases you should be done within 15 seconds. Just one thing to note, just because the calibration has stopped moving the gimbal doesn't mean it's done. So in this case, look at the camera. It was still moving left, right, up, down, but at the end you can see that it did a bit of a small little movement as if it was powering down. So in this case, the calibration is now complete, and I'll show you how it works with a Mavic Air 2. So exactly the same thing. You take a look at your documentation, you make sure you got the correct COM port as well as the drone model number, and then you will just replace it in your script. So in this case, I've already copied it and pasted it into another document, and makes it quite easy because all I need to do is just copy paste the command and I can run it quite easily. You can save it on your machine, maybe for future use as well, but in this case it's such an easy process to go through that you can easily just swap out model numbers as well as port numbers whenever you connect a new drone to your machine. So the Air 2 has a very similar process how it runs through with like the Mavic 2, but as soon as you go to the other drones like the Air 1 and the Spark, you'll see the process changes slightly. So hope this helps you guys. Please remember, if there's anything that's unclear, just post it in the comments below and hopefully I can help you guys out. Please enjoy the rest of the video. I'm just going to show you how the calibration completes on the Mavic Air 2 as well as the Mavic Air 1.